Now, the World Health Organization expected to hold an emergency meeting today concerning the coronavirus. The agency now reporting nearly 8,000 cases of the illness and 170 deaths. Most of those cases are in China. But keep in mind, there are 5 confirmed cases in the United States. The New York City Department of Health monitoring the situation very closely. In fact, the commissioner is here, Dr. Barba, joining us with a very local update to what is happening this morning. So let's first talk about, should New Yorkers, thank you for coming in, should New Yorkers actually be concerned about the coronavirus? Is there anything right now that shows that it could be here in New York?
So this is a new virus in an existing family of viruses. And we are concerned that we're seeing every day a quick increase in the number of individuals who get the infection and who are dying. But we want to reassure New Yorkers that the local risk is low and that our preparedness is high. And so the message to New Yorkers is go about your daily lives, but pay attention to what's going on.
So when you say you're prepared, how do you prepare for something that has never been in existence before?
So we have measures in place. We're working with the CDC, with our state health department colleagues. We have been screening, the CDC has been screening people coming in from airports. We work with the provider community so that if somebody is feeling sick and has just returned from Wuhan in the last 14 days, the message is they should call their doctor. Their doctor does an everyday test to rule out, is it, you know, just common flu? Or could this be something else? And then they call us to see if we need to take it further and test them for corona.
So this is the, I think, so many people are plagued by, right? Is unlike SARS and Ebola, which were different and you experienced different symptoms, you could be walking around after touching the subway pole and say, I feel like I have the flu. So how do you know it's time to go get tested for something else?
So chances are you do have the flu because we are in flu season, and I want to remind New Yorkers it's not too late to get the flu vaccine. The important thing here is that there's no indication that casual contact, just going through the subway, is in any way, shape, or form a risk factor.
Because look at these symptoms: fever, headache, runny nose, cough, shortness of breath. This is every day.
Every day. So that's why it's important for people who have traveled to the Wuhan area and have returned in the last 14 days, who are feeling sick with those symptoms, call their doctors.
And to be clear, when you say a prolonged exposure, meaning if I grab the subway pole that had, what, droplets on? Because how is it spread?
Yeah. Right now, we're learning every day about how this virus behaves. And best as we can determine, it's spread by respiratory contact, meaning someone who coughs, sneezes, doesn't cover their nose and mouth, spreads that, and then comes in contact with you.
Which brings me to what I saw yesterday in the drugstore, right? Front and center, throw the picture up, front and center at the register, was an image of these masks here, right? The N95 masks. Do these do anything? You're seeing more and more people actually walk around with these now.
Yeah. You know, there is no indication to be using masks here in New York City. I suppose that for some people, it gives them peace of mind. But in reality, what it does, I think, is give people a false sense of security. Mm-hmm. The best way to guard against this potential threat, and again, I want to remind New Yorkers the risk is low, is to wash your hands often. Cover your nose and your mouth when you cough or sneeze. And if you are feeling sick, call your doctor. Don't go to work, don't go to school until you've been evaluated.
So wearing the mask, you could still potentially get it.
Yeah, because the behavior of individuals is such that they're inconsistent in the use, right? And so when you take a phone call, when you have to scratch your nose and you remove the mask, and you're not washing your hands as you should, then you're not really, you know, measuring up to how the mask could best be used. But again, in New York City, there's no indication to do that.